So in our neighborhood, the International District, we have, you know, we're on top of the aquifer as well. And we have the Kirtland Air Force Base, which is really close. And in 1953, they replaced pipes poorly. And so jet fuel was just leaking into the soil. And in fact, it leaked so far that somebody was like running and they saw a slick of oil floating on the surface. So the thing is that sitting on top of our aquifer, which is the thing that made settlement possible, that's like our, you know, that's our water, that's like the precious resource of Albuquerque. It's not just about the neighborhood of the International District, but all over Albuquerque. And that there, you know, not too far from where the jet fuel spill is the Ridgecrest 5 wells, and they pump water for the city. So they're pumping this water for the city, and it's dragging the plume towards these wells. This is where we get our drinking water from. And when I first learned about it, I learned about it with my friend Bernadette, and we were just like, we were in a geology class. We lived in the International District. We were like, where is this at? On, you know, mapping this area that was essentially where we lived. And then we were like, whoa, there's a jet fuel spill? So I became a part of the International District Healthy Communities Coalition. And I asked the people in that community, like, what do you know about the jet fuel spill? So we did a community-based participatory research exercise. I know it's a big word. Basically, it's just like people coming together. And it turned out there was actually a lot of knowledge in that room. So people shared with each other what they knew. We didn't have to go get it from some expert person. Like, we had it all there. And then someone asked me, aren't there plants? Healing, can we use these plants that are used for healing also for the healing of the earth? And so those are some of the plants that I was looking at. So plants like Yerba de la Negrita, like Cola de Caballo, and then we looked at girasol, like we looked at sunflower. And then when I mentioned sunflower, it was like something clicked and like lit up in people. So we started to plant gardens. These gardens are rain gardens. We do it for free. They require very little water. We plant plants that are native to the area. And then hopefully as they mature, the idea is, that are these plants capable of picking up some of this toxic vapor? I told my mentor at the time, I was like, okay, so this is what I'm interested in doing. And he was like, why don't you call yourself Sunflowers for Change? The sunflower is like a representative of how we're proud about living in our community and how we care about our community. So it's like, you put these sunflowers up, it's not about the base. It's about the fact that we care about our communities. And we're beautifying the space, you know? We're gonna do our gathering together, our belief in the work that we do, we're gonna do it in a way that is fun, that is joyful, that uplifts people, that connects people. Because like that kind of, you know, water is that. Water is that connection. As a community, we're tied to the earth. We're tied to the water. You know, it is our blood, you know. Water are the veins that connect us as a body of people, you know. And that there have been people here for thousands of years, you know. This is our lifeblood. It's also our birthright, this water. And that means that it's our duty to protect this, you know, like to protect it and to defend it and fight for it. Son las tres de la mañana. Dicen que pena un santo.